So all the people, I know you are encouraged, you are filled with more power and anointing. Praise the Lord. Today I didn't get in a translator. Yesterday a translator was there. Tomorrow there will be a translator. Tomorrow I will be preaching the gospel. I want to do my personal things. Praise the Lord. And after that, praise the Lord. I want to meet all my expenses. Am I right? Praise the Lord. So I want to do, I have lots of personal things. Praise the Lord. To do. Praise the Lord. After that, I will go and preach the gospel. I will work for the kingdom. Praise the Lord. I will also work for the world. Praise the Lord. And world means to meet all my things. Praise the Lord. So I will, most of the time, I'm working for the kingdom of God. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. This is a first designation ever our God has given to Pastor Joel. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I want to announce to everybody after a short break. Again, I start to preach the gospel in Harvest TV. This will be a non-stop. Every week, this will be continuously, it will going on. Praise the Lord, Harvest TV. If it is possible, we will be changing. The timing also will change it later on. Praise the Lord. Thank you very much. Please watch online. It is available. More than 500,000 people are watching in the TV. You can watch. Praise the Lord. And all over the nations. And it is available on YouTube. It is available in Facebook and social medias and all the time. Praise the Lord. Join with us and please pray for me to get a on TV channel for Shake the Nations. So 24 hours we can broadcast this revival meeting. Praise the Lord. And also we can give chance to everybody. Those who are preaching or singing the song, they can also preach doing their ministry in our TV. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Our God is a faithful God. Another thing I want to say to all the people, praise the Lord. Join with us every day. This gospel revival, this God will heal you. Praise the Lord. So today, we are going to start. Praise the Lord. Couple of worshipers are there. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Join here. This is the more than 350 days are over. Continuously, we were doing this without any fail. Every day, we were doing non-stop gospel revival. Thank you very much. All the people are joining here. Lots of ministers, more than 300 ministers had been in this flight tour. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So, if possible, we will meet again, everybody all together in one time, in one day. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I will be meeting everybody. That will be a mega anniversary. Praise the Lord. We will be arranged. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So that I'm praying to Lord how I want to do it. Because 1 year is going to reach. It will get reached soon. So that will be a mega revival. Praise the Lord. In between, after lockdown period get over, we want to arrange a crusade from city to city. And all the, not only in UK, but in all the nations. Praise the Lord. Join with us. All the participants, those who had been in this flight tour, you will be the main person standing for that crusade. Praise the Lord. Pastor Jolly also will be traveling from UK to your country and attending that crusade. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I will be there everywhere because Jesus Christ has appointed me as an apostle. I hope you are also, your position also an apostle position. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We can work together in Christ Jesus. So now, thus, Shake the Nation non-stop gospel revival is going to start right now. We can pray one accord to the world right now. Praise the Lord. Can I invite, can Sister Tosin, can I invite you to pray a couple of minutes time before starting this session?
Hallelujah. Father, we just want to say thank you. Thank you for another blessed and wonderful moment in your presence. We thank you, Lord, because wherever two or three are gathered together in your name, there you are in their midst. We thank you because you're here to honor us and to bless us with your presence, with your glory, and with your power being made manifest in every life. As we go on in this service, worshiping your name, lifting your name up, and sharing the word, and just having a great time in your presence, you will feed us, you will touch us, and we will never remain the same at the end of this time. We release your glory, we release your presence, the freedom even to worship you, to lift up our voices and to just let go in your presence and to receive from you, from your spirit, oh God. We ask that Holy Spirit himself would take control of this service. He will do what only he can do. He will set the captives free. He will shake our lives lives, it will shake the nations, and it will cause there to be a revival even to start within our lives that will spread to the nations of the world in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we thank you because you are a good, good Father and that you always hear our prayers. We thank you, Lord Jesus, because this is the confidence we have in you, that whenever we call upon you, you always hear us and you always grant us the answers to our petition. And as we have prayed to you tonight, as we continue, oh God, in this service, we receive everything that you have on your heart for us tonight in the name of Jesus. Thank you, everlasting Father, in advance of what you're going to do, in advance of the miracles that you're going to do in every life, in advance of the chains that will be broken, in advance, oh God, of the great and mighty things that we're going to receive at your hand. We say thank you, Lord. Receive all our praises. Receive all our worship. We ask that all the people that you have proposed to be blessed in this service, you begin to bring them in. You begin to call them in, oh God, for them to come and receive that which you have planned for them tonight in the name of Jesus. Thank you, everlasting Father, because we pray in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Somebody want to shout and say amen. Praise the Lord with the greatest power. If I'm not doing this gospel revival, I'm so much upset. It is so that every day, even when I'm preaching the gospel in the street, even if a little bit late, I will come and do this. This is non-stop. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Only Sunday, we will not do it. Sunday, I'm doing the online church service. And physically, we will do the church service. When I have two churches in London, praise the Lord. And I want to preach, and the pastor to preach the two churches. Praise the Lord. God is giving the ministers my church. Praise the Lord in future. So when the Sunday, I will little bit occupy busy day. I want to preach two churches. So Sunday, there is no gospel revival, but our church program will be available in YouTube and Facebook Live Center. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So everybody, join with us. First of all, Bridget and Benita, join here. Sister Tosin is here. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. They are the children studying. Praise the Lord. God bless you. You have lots of study and everything. Can I invite you to start the praise and worship on the 20 to 25 minute time right now? Praise the Lord. After that, Sister Tosin can take over this session. Thank you.
Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Greetings to you all in the precious name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. We're so happy to be here once again on this platform. Shake the nations once more and glorify His name with you all again. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. God has shown His love and compassion upon us, and He has brought us together in His name, in His presence. Amen. So let us glorify His name. Let us sing praise to Him. Amen. For He has shown His overflowing love, His amazing grace. Amen. And His great mercy upon us. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. We thank you, Lord. Amen. God said, if there are two more gathered together in my name, I will be in their midst. Lord, we believe your presence is in our midst today, Lord. We believe your presence is here with us today, Father.
Thank you. Hosanna, Hosanna,
Hallelujah. The song is called David Dance Day, and hallelujah. I will Thank you.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Now, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. A couple of minutes we can pray for the world right now. Praise the Lord. More time we'll get intercession prayer. As we know that one, this is a non-stop gospel revival. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Whenever we are having very busy working outside, that time, sometimes we'll do early time or we'll do the later on like that. But every day, this time will be there. Only one thing, we have to see the world gospel revival in our eyes. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. This is a non-stop. Praise the Lord. I want to encourage all the people are doing the revival or any of the, that gospel message when you are sharing by Zoom or anything by the time of lockdown started. If you can continue this one and reserve this time for time to stand, spread the gospel, and rest of the time you do other works. Praise the Lord. This is a gospel revival. Please don't say any other excuse from this to spread the gospel. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Because to get this, lots of people are waiting to get this gospel message in their life. Lots of people are the brokenhearted people. They are in the point of the death. Because of our gospel message, praise the Lord, because of this power of the gospel, they can come back from their death to their life. Praise the Lord. Please raise your hand. We can pray for the world gospel revival. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I pray for UK and Europe and all the people, those who are doing the ministry work, Father. Holy Spirit, thank you for your taking care in the entire cities, Heavenly Father. Holy Spirit, thank you for your taking care in all the cities, from city to city, from nation to nation. The people are doing any of the gospel work in and out, especially in the state. Give protection, Father. The people, especially the Gentiles, Father, let them come to know by praying. Let them receive the healing so that they can come back to the Lord. Father God, I pray for the revival, gospel revival for all the African countries, Father, including South Africa, Nigeria, Zimbabwe, and Tanzania, and all the countries. I pray for the gospel revival for Australia and Canada and North and South America, to all the countries, Father. I pray for all the people, minister, those who are doing for gospel work, Father. Bless them, Father. Keep them in your glory, Father. Heavenly Father, I pray for all the people are watching in Asian countries, Heavenly Father, including Middle East. I pray for Malaysia and all the countries, those who are not accepting Jesus Christ is their Lord and Savior. Within the year of 2021, let them start to accept this powerful gospel in their heart and mind, Father. I pray for all the India, all the provinces, all the states, Father. Let them receive this mighty power of the Lord, Father. I pray for all the ministers, those who have been in this platform, Father. Bless them abundantly. Let them go with the highest, the greatest anointing and power, Father. Let them fill with more power and anointing from the Holy Spirit, Father. Give more revelation and power, Father. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Amen. Somebody wants to shout and say amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Again, another 20 minutes worship. I'm inviting Sister Tosin. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Continue. So worship is continuing. After that, Pastor Philippine are taking over the word of God. After that, the worshipers are still available. Again, you can sing so. Again, you will close this session. Praise the Lord. This will be a glorious and powerful session. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. God bless you. Sister Tosin, you are invited another 20 to 25 minute time to worship. Thank you.
Father, we just bless your name. Hallelujah. Thank you so much, Sisters Benita and Bettina. God bless you. Powerful worship. I was blessed. It's a joyful thing when we come together to worship the Lord, because in the presence, in the atmosphere of worship, anything can happen. When we lift up our voices in one accord, anything can happen. I remember when King Jehoshaphat was going into battle, they sent the praiser, the worshippers ahead of them. They raised the hallelujah to the Lord. And before they got to the battle, the Lord Almighty has already won their battle for them. So I want to encourage you tonight, if you're in any situation, to raise a hallelujah to the Lord of Lords and to the King of Kings. And as we go into another wonderful time of worship, now you just lift up your voice, lose yourself in the atmosphere, and just worship the Lord. Lift up his name, worship him with an abandonment, and you will see the great and mighty things that he will begin to do in your life. So our first song that we're going to sing tonight is called Raise a Hallelujah. Raise a hallelujah in the midst of your enemies. When you're going through trials, raise a hallelujah. When you're going through temptation, raise a hallelujah. When the enemy seems like he's just coming against you, raise a hallelujah. And as you lift up your voices and you raise a hallelujah to the King of Glory, to the Lord of Lords, gates and everlasting doors will be lifted, and the King of Glory will come in, and it will be glorified in your life. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the hallelujah. In the presence of my enemies, I raise a hallelujah louder than the unbelief. I raise a hallelujah, my voice is a melody. I raise a hallelujah. Heaven comes to fight for me.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Father, we worship your name. Father, we magnify your name because you're a good, good Father. We thank you as we raise a hallelujah to you. We thank you because your name is being glorified in this place, and your glory fills the whole temple in the name of Jesus. Oh, the overwhelming, reckless love of the Lord. As we sing tonight, we're just going to sing to the love of Christ. We're going to sing reckless love. His love for us is unquantifiable. We cannot compare his love to anything. He gave everything up just to save us, just to die and to redeem us from our sins and from the hands of him who is stronger than us. And his love is everlasting, is from everlasting to everlasting. His agape love is unconditional. He will do anything for you and I. So we sing reckless love tonight to his name. Hallelujah. For I spoke a word, you were singing over me. Jesus, you have been so, so good to me. Yeah. Before I took a breath, you breathed your life in me. You have been so, so kind to me. And oh yeah, nothing ever ending, reckless love of God. Holy Jesus,
yeah.
Hallelujah. His love is indeed overwhelming. His love is reckless. His love will tear down any mountain, will break down any wall just to reach you and I. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. We're going to sing another song. It's a prayer that the Lord will open up our eyes, to open up our ears, to open our eyes that we may see him enthroned high and lifted up as the King of glory, as the Lord of lords. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. One who reigns forever and he is indescribable.
Every creature you look in the sun and you see.
You're an amazing God. You are the uncontainable God. And we thank you for your presence in this place. For you are here to deliver. You are here to do great and mighty things because you are the way maker. You promised that you will make a way in the wilderness and you will cause there to be rivers of water in the desert. Who is like unto you, our God? Oh, yes, you are our way maker, our promise keeper. And as we worship you, oh God, we magnify your name. We say, come and make a way in our lives. In the name of Jesus. Oh, thank you, Jesus. You are here, moving in on me. I worship you. I worship you. You are here, working in this place. I worship you. I worship you. You are here, moving in our midst. Oh, I worship you, Lord. I worship you. You are here, working in this place. I worship you. Yes, I worship you. Hey, you are waymaker, miracle worker, promise keep, hide in the darkness, my God. That is who you are. Yes, you are waymaker, miracle worker, promise keep, light in the darkness, my God. That is who you are. You are here. Hey! Turn your eyes around, Jesus. I worship you. Lord, I worship you. I worship you. You are here. Mighty name we have worshipped. Amen. Amen.
Thank you very much. Powerful worship. Everybody, please give wonderful talk to Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord. Jesus Christ's name is, he is a miracle Lord, miracle worker. Praise the Lord. This is our God. That is what King David says. If God is with us, God is our God, Jesus Christ, our Heavenly Father, is standing in my right hand. So because of this reason, I will not fear. I will not afraid anybody, any of the enemies, because I'm not going by my power. I'm going by the power of the Heavenly Father, by the power of the Holy Spirit. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So that each and every people, you have to say from your mouth, from your tongue, today, I will not fear anybody because our God is for us. Who can stand against me? Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So that everybody, go wherever you are, run with the gospel. Our God will be with you. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Sister Tosin. Powerful worship. Pastor Mike, can I invite you to pray for and this again for the world, the gospel revival, and pray for Sister Chosin, and can you please, and also can I invite you to pray for our next session and preaching. Praise the Lord. Pastor Mike, you are invited in a few minutes time to pray. Thank you.
Let's bow our heads in prayer. Father, we come before you right now, once again, in the name above all, the name that the devil knows, the name that can do what no man can do, the name of Jesus Christ. We pray for our sister Tosin, my God. Yes, Lord, for wonderful ministry of music, wonderful ministry, my God, of praising you, worshiping you. We are blessed, Father. Bless you as well, in the name of Jesus. As she has blessed us, my God, bless you as well. Father, we thank you for your goodness. We thank you for your kindness. We glorify your name. We give you praise. As you have said in your word, man shall not live on bread alone. Yes, Lord, today we are ready to receive fresh bread from above, bread begged from heaven, bread of life. Not this bread we eat here. When we finish it, we are hungry again. And we want to thank you for the word that is coming before us, my God, as I pray for the man of God, Philip Hand, who is going to share the word, Father. Kura mande boshanda makasa. Yes, Lord, be with him, Father. Yes, Lord, you have already anointed him, Father. He's ready to give us what you have given to him. We pray for our hearts. Anyone, my God, who's going to listen to the word, my God, that we cool down, sit down, and, my God, eat properly and hear properly, because it is the word that builds us up. Without the word, we can never be built. It is the word that formed the foundation of the word, the world. It is the word that came, which was and which is and is to come. It is the word that lives forever. Everything else, my God, will pass away, but your word abides forever. That's the word we are waiting for. That's the word we are ready for. That's the word you have for us. We are not here by mistake. Today, you heard it, Father, that we must be here because of good news for us. And we are ready, Father, to accept and receive. And we are expecting you to move in our lives. We are expecting your word to change us, your word to shape us, your word as to put us right with you, my God. Yes, it is the word. Yes, it is the word. Yes, it is the word. As you say, your word, my God, will not return void, but it will accomplish that which it is sent for. Yes, we believe it, Father. Today, what we are going to receive, it's going to accomplish something in our lives. It's going to accomplish everything in our lives, because your word is full of mercy, full of grace, full of healing, full of everything, Father, we need. It's in your word. We thank you for your word. We thank you, Lord. Ready we are. May your name be glorified. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you very much. All the nations wake up today because of this gospel. Praise the powerful gospel. Gospel is the power of the word. Praise the Lord. Wherever preaching the gospel, if you are receiving this gospel message is yours, there will be healing. There is a miracle. There is a wonderful things will happen in your life. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. God bless you. Thank you very much, Pastor Mike. God bless you, everybody. Now this is a thing to hear the word of God. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I'm inviting Pastor Philip. Had been here a couple of times. Praise the Lord. Again here to preach the gospel to the nations. Praise the Lord. Pastor Philip will be sharing the gospel another 40 to 45 minutes time. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Pastor Philip is from Manchester. Praise the Lord. Serving our Lord many years. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Pastor Philip, you are invited. Shake the Nations UK is inviting you to share the word of God right now. You are invited.
God bless you. Thank you, Pastor Jolly. Thank you once again for being part of what God's doing through your life and through your ministry. It's always an honor to be with you and to share the word of God with the people listening. So thank you to the worship team. Thank you to Pastor Mike. It's been just a tremendous program so far. And I just want to say that the Lord's anointing is being felt during the time of worship, during the time of prayer, and I believe during the time of word also, because, you know, signs and wonders follow preaching the word. And that the signs and wonders we're talking about, of course, is people encountering Jesus, encountering their healing, but most of all, encountering their salvation. And really, it's a work of the Holy Spirit. And so we're thankful to God that he is moving in this ministry through the power of God. And we're just being blessed and touched by all that God is doing through you, Pastor Jolly. So I want to bring the word of God. It's Palm Sunday. On Sunday, it's the Easter time, the Passover begins, and it's a special time as Jesus enters Jerusalem and goes towards his destiny to die on the cross for you and for me. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. So the thing that I want to look at is that one of my favorite messages. I may have even preached it before, and you may have heard it before, because it's a favorite, and it's the triumphal entry of Jesus Christ. In fact, it's the moments leading up to Jesus encountering Jerusalem, and then the events unfolding over the next few days leading to his arrest, you know, the events of the Last Supper, the events in the Garden of Gethsemane, and, you know, the tremendous torture and pain he went through on his way to the cross, and where he gave his life willingly for you and for me. Oh, glory to the name of Jesus. I believe as we prophesy the name of Jesus to our situations, as we declare the healing that is in him and in his stripes that was on his back and the piercings on his hands and feet, we will be touched. I believe in the power of the blood of Jesus to wash away sins completely and make us white as snow. It's not our effort, it's all him. All we do is respond to what Jesus has done. And can I tell you, all through the earthly ministry of Jesus Christ, he came to demonstrate God's love and God's compassion for you and for me. And one of the great stories that I love so much in the Word of God is this story of the donkey carrying Jesus into the holy city. And you find it in Matthew 21. And if we look there, what happened is Jesus came in verse 1, I believe, there. He came to the hillside, to the Mount of Olives, and he was near a place called Bethpage, which is a place called the House of Figs. And as he looked down from the hillside into this town, he decided to send two disciples on a mission into the town. And the town, of course, is Bethpage, the House of Figs. And if you think about that, the figs, what do the figs represent? Well, the figs represent a false covering. Remember in the Garden of Eden, when Adam and Eve disobeyed God, and they, Adam willingly sinned, and Eve was deceived. What did they do? Well, they tied fig leaves together to try and cover their exposed nakedness towards God. They try to cover up their sin. And so I believe this place, the place of figs, is a picture, is a metaphor for a cover up. It's a place where sin dwells, but it's trying to be hidden. But can I tell you, when Jesus is near, his eyes see all. And I don't know what situation you're in. I don't know what town you're in. I don't know what city you're in, or even I don't even know what country you're watching from this evening. But I welcome you to the program. I believe that Jesus is near, very near to you right now. And Jesus is looking down upon your place, looking down upon your life, and he's seeing how you've tried to handle life, how you've tried to deal with sin, how you've tried to get free from the things that have chained you and bound you. And can I tell you, Jesus Christ is sending two witnesses, a witness and a word, the Spirit and the Word tonight, into your home, into your life, into your place. I'm preaching, the Holy Spirit's doing the rest. I believe this witness is coming to visit you where you're at tonight. Glory to God. I believe God is so near that he wants to set you free. He doesn't want you covered up. He wants you revealed, and he wants Christ to be revealed in you. Glory to God. He wants you to carry the presence of God into your next place, into the bigger things God's got for you. And we're going to see that as we move along. So here they're into this village they go, and Jesus says, you'll find to the disciples, you'll find a donkey and a colt. You'll find this mother and child donkey, and they'll be tied up, and go and loose them and bring them to me. And they say, well, what if somebody says, what are you doing with that donkey? What do you think you're doing? Jesus said simply, tell them that the Lord has need, and they will release them immediately. Glory to God. When God speaks, you can be free from whatever taskmaster's holding you down, holding you back. I want to tell you this. I don't know what situation you're in. Maybe you're a single mother. Maybe you're a single father. Maybe you're not even been married, but you feel that you're tied up. Your employer has locked you up. Your life situation has put a heavy burden on you to the bear, that you can't get free. You just can't. You want your children to be free, but they can't be free. You seem to be locked in this situation, never ending situation of being struggling and being abused, maybe, what can I tell you? You need to be free. And the word of the Lord is saying, loose and set free to you tonight. Oh, somebody's going to receive that message. I feel it right now. Somebody is receiving the message of being free. Free not by doing things to make yourself free, but free by receiving the word of God that's come to set you free. Glory to God by the power of the Holy Spirit. Oh, thank you, Jesus, for what you're doing in the viewer's life right now. And so I want to tell you this simple thing is we have to be obedient to go when Jesus sends us. You see, people are trapped. People are stuck. People are chained up in their lives and they're not free because you have not gone. Jesus said, go into all the world and preach the gospel. Maybe I'm speaking to you, young evangelist. Maybe I'm speaking to you that you haven't gone. You haven't obeyed the word. Well, can I tell you, the blessing that needs to be released is in your obedience. So can I be so clear here? Go. If you've had a word from Jesus telling you to go and to do something, you must do it. Otherwise, you're not going to be free. And the person's not going to be free. And the situation's not going to get any better. Look at the life of Jonah. He had a word from God to go and preach to his enemies. And what did he do? He ran in the other direction, but God wouldn't let him go. God trapped him and kept him. And even actually, he killed him in the belly of the whale. But that's another story for another day. This is how mighty my God is. If he can raise Jonah from the dead, he can raise Jesus from the dead. And if he can raise Jesus from the dead, he can raise you from your situation too. I declare it in the mighty name of Jesus tonight that somebody is going to be free indeed. And so here, this situation is dependent on you going, disciple. It's dependent on you witnessing, disciple. It's dependent on you. Jesus has given you the authority. Jesus has given you the word. You need to get the release and go right now to where God's calling you to. And where God calls you to will be a place of challenge. It will be a place where people are in need. It'll be a place where the people are trapped, generations are trapped, and they need loosing, they need freeing, and they need a word come in to do it. And can I tell you, you are God's mouthpiece, my friend. So here we are, at the disciples have obeyed, the disciples have gone down the hillside, the disciples have gone and they've found this donkey and the colt, and they've started to untie her, and the owner comes out and says, what are you doing? What are you doing? And they said, the Lord has need of them. Can I tell you, when the Lord speaks, your problems are dealt with. And can I tell you, the Lord spoke before you were ever created, and he had a plan to redeem you, a plan to save you, and a plan to heal you. Oh, the Lord has already spoke before this world was ever created. He has spoken about you. He has written about you. He is writing your story. It's time for you to respond and say, Lord, let me go. Lord, loose me. Lord, I want to travel. I want to encounter Jesus. I want to do things. I did want to do exploits for God. Can I tell you, this is in you. You need to stir this up. You need to receive this message, and you need to believe the word from heaven, which is that Jesus is coming back one day to free us all. Glory to God. In the meantime, these disciples start to move up the mountainside. They start to lead the donkeys up the mountainside, and they're talking about Jesus. They're talking about how did Jesus know that this man would let these donkeys go. Can I tell you, because he's the king from heaven, because he's the Lord God Almighty, because he is the only one wise, he is the true master, he is the master of all, and when he speaks, he has authority over all. Oh, glory to God. God has seen your heart, seen your situation, and he's going to deal with you in one way. He's going to tell you to loose something, or he's going to tell you to free someone. Oh, it's time for forgiveness to reign in your life and let God take control. Give God what belongs to him. Glory to God. It's time to move into your destiny. It's time to be free, and free indeed. So here, these men, these two disciples are walking with these donkeys, and they're speaking about Jesus. They're talking about the miracles. They're talking that in the next few days it's going to be crazy. That who knows what could happen. We know that the religious people hate us. The religious people want to kill Jesus, but Jesus is going into the place of the religion. He's going into the place where they want to kill him. Can I tell you, Jesus is even coming into the place where you've rejected him. It's time for you to open your heart tonight. It's time for you to say, sorry, Lord, I need you in my life. It's time for you to encounter Jesus, and you do it by believing in him. Glory to God. You don't do it any other way. And so here, these disciples, maybe they were talking about the miracles. Maybe they were talking about the passion that Jesus had for the leper, the untouchable, how he embraced him, how he held him, how he loved him who was sick and dying. Then maybe they're talking about the ones Jesus raised from the dead. Maybe he's talking about Lazarus, who couldn't even come out of the tomb because he was dead. But he responded to the word. The word of Jesus Christ is here to raise you from your situation. Receive it in Jesus' mighty name. And so maybe they were talking about Jesus still in the storm, the storms of life when all seemed lost. Jesus got up and he spoke to the storm and said, peace. Be still. Can I tell you, whatever storm you're in, whatever situation you're going through right now, whatever seems to be taking you down, can I tell you, it's time for you to say, Jesus, cry out on my behalf. And you know, Jesus is there in heaven, standing, interceding for those who believe him. So interceding, it means he's praying for you and for me. He's singing over us. He's watching over us. He's seeing our hardships. He's seeing our situations, and he's longing to bring us into fellowship with him. But sometimes the journey is a little bit uphill. Sometimes the journey is a little bit dangerous. Sometimes the journey is fearful because it's the unknown. But can I tell you, there's no better call than to rise to meet Jesus. There's no better call than to respond to the call of God on your life. Can I encourage you? I don't know your situation, but God does. I don't know what the devil's planned to do with you, but God has counteracted it. God has made a way through his blood and through his sacrifice on the cross for you to be free. Oh, I can't preach about the cross enough, but it's the cross of Jesus Christ that changed everything for us. And it's the power of the resurrection which demonstrates the power of the cross and the blood of Jesus that was shed on that cross. Oh, glory to God. I know some of you might get angry. You might get cross with me. But can I tell you, you would have crucified Jesus. We all was. We was there in the crowd. Our ancestors were there saying, crucify him. And you know what? It's true that he needed to die because he needed to represent you and me. We needed our sins dealt with. We needed our sickness dealt with, and religion just won't cover it any longer. You know, the idea that God doesn't exist is not going to cut it when God comes for his church. Glory to God. You must put your faith in Jesus and the finished work of the cross. And so here, this donkey is getting closer. It's walking with the disciples, hearing about Jesus. And this donkey is then suddenly, the disciples take off their coats and lay them across the back of the donkey. And the donkey is saying, wow, such honor, such praise, such gifts to cover us from the beating hot sun. And you see, that is how we perceive what God does for us. We think it's all about us. We think it's about how we look. I think it's about what people think of us. Can I tell you, no, those coats, those mantles were placed on top of the donkey's shoulders, not for the donkey, but for Jesus to be comfortable. So when Jesus sits on the donkey, when Jesus rests on the donkey that carries Jesus into the city, the donkey thinks it's got a coat to make it better. But really, the coat is just to make the presence of Jesus more comfortable. Glory to God. And can I tell you, I believe that some of you are moving higher in the things of God tonight because you're believing the word of God. I believe some of you are pressing in to encounter Jesus. You're hungry for more, and Jesus is placing a new mantle on you, not for your glory, not for your praise, not for your magnification. No, it's for his presence to come and to rest upon you. Glory to God, because God wants you to carry him in the next part of your life, into the next part of your journey. God wants you to be carrying him into the places you go. It's no more being tied up. It's no more doing nothing for God. It's time now to carry God into the blessings that God is expecting you to go into. Glory to God. And so here they start to walk down the hillside, and the crowd comes out, and the crowd is cheering. The crowd is placing palm trees on the floor. They're placing their coats on the floor. They're singing Hosanna to the Son of David, and they're giving Jesus his rightful place. But Jesus, even Jesus, didn't come with pride. He came on a humble donkey into that city. And even in that place where the people are praising the King of Kings and they're glorifying Jesus in his rightful place, the religious comes out, and the religious said, "We don't think it's good, Jesus, for these people to be like this." Can I tell you, the religious will always tell you it's never good. They never bring good news. Religious people always bring negativity. They always bring the atmosphere down. They always say how you shouldn't, not how you should. You see, worship is not about folding your arms and looking grumpy. Worship is about raising your hands and getting into the praise of God, giving him everything. That's true worship. David danced. We sang it earlier. David danced round and he didn't care what he looked like. He was the king, can I tell you, or the king to be. You know, it doesn't matter what you look like. What matters is, are you praising God? Are you worshiping God? Are you receiving Jesus? Or are you being religious, saying, I don't like this kind of preaching. I don't like this kind of message. I don't need this kind of religion. Can I tell you, you don't need any religion. You need Jesus Christ. You need him more than ever. Don't reject Jesus because of this messenger. Embrace Jesus, knowing that he is the one and true God, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. Oh, glory to God. You know, Jesus went in, and you know, he went straight into that city, straight in to clash with religious people. And you know, he went in, and what does he do when he comes in this triumphal entry? Well, he finds himself in the temple with all the religion, all the money changers, all the deceivers, all the scandalous people who are trying to profiteer out of the church, all those people that are there saying, oh, your sacrifice is not good enough. Oh, you're going to need a better sacrifice. And they were just swindlers and diddlers. You'll find the church is full of people like that, but Jesus is driving them out. And maybe you're a little bit like that. Maybe your ministry is more about the money than it is about people. Maybe your ministry is all a little bit about how much religion you can impose on others, how much condemnation to make you feel better, you wicked sinner. Can I tell you, Jesus is going to deal with you as a just God, as a just Lord and a just Savior. And he dealt with those money changers. He didn't act in anger. He was angry. He went and he made a whip. He went and he fashioned a rope into a whip. And then he went and he drove out the money changers. He turned over their tables. The shock, the horror. See, Jesus isn't coming to make religion comfortable. He's coming to clean house. He's coming to get rid of what's wrong. So when you're inviting Jesus in, be sure that Jesus is going to start a work in you, cleaning some things out that shouldn't be there, some attitudes, some thoughts, some deeds that shouldn't be there. Well, Jesus is going to deal with them. Jesus is going to turn your world upside down. He's going to change your situations. He's going to drive out the false. He's going to drive out the crazy stupidity that religion brings. And he's going to bring the place of prayer back, the place of peace back. You know, we've been studying the word of God in our church, and we've been studying the word, and we've been looking at the word, and often the word pray means to worship God. We take prayer like we take a list to Santa. Oh, I want this, God, for Easter. I want this for Christmas. I want this for my birthday. Can I tell you, you deserve nothing, but what God gives you is a blessing, abundance, and more than you could think or imagine. But you have to surrender all. You have to start praying and worshiping, not praying a list, not praying a request, but praying to worship God. You get up to encounter him. You're getting into the place where you're worshiping him, and out of the place of worship, God is answering all your desires. He knows what you need. He knows what you think. He knows what you want. And can I tell you, he'll change your desires so that you desire more of him. Glory to God. So in this place of change, religion is going to be offended. But can I tell you, it's in the place of change. It's in the place of letting God go and to do what God has to do in you. That's the place. That's the place of encountering God. And that's the place to get into your miracle. You see, what happens is after Jesus cleanses the temple, after Jesus cleanses that place of God, where he gets rid of false religion, he gets rid of corrupt religious practices. And what's he do? He then has made it a house of worship and prayer once again. He's then made it a place for miracles. Glory to God. And we read that in verse 14, that the blind and the lame came to him in that place. After he'd driven out all that nonsense, after he'd got rid of the false sham, after he'd brought back worship and prayer, after he'd made himself the center there, then the miracles of healing, the blind eyes would open. The people who couldn't walk properly would walk. Oh, glory to God. This is the place of healing. It's the place that's invited Jesus in. It's in the place that's allowed Jesus to clean up. It's in the place that has reestablished relationship with God, not through a false cover-up, through a false fig, or through a false sacrifice. It's a place where they've received Jesus. Is the place of miracles. Glory to God. Glory to God. Can I tell you, it's in your place where you receive Jesus. It's going to be the place that you receive your miracle. I want you to put out doubt. I want you to cast out fear. I want you to believe Jesus with all your heart. And with all your mouth giving praise, say, thank you, Jesus, for my healing. Thank you, Jesus, for my salvation. Oh, come, Lord, have your way in me. Come, Lord, clean me up from the inside out. Come, Lord, reestablish a relationship with me so that I can worship you and not run from you any longer. Oh, Lord, come and heal me and make me whole from the inside out. Glory to God. Give me eyes to see what you're doing. Give me strength to carry you into the next thing. Oh, this becomes our lifestyle. This becomes our praise. And, you know, Jesus said, they're calling out, Hosanna to the Son of David. And the religious get offended. Oh, glory to God. But Jesus said, out of the mouth of babies and nursing infants, little ones, you have perfected praise. Can I tell you, you can come with your PhD, you can come with your degree, you can come with your arguments, you can come with your conspiracy theories, you can come with all your legal jargon, you can come with all that, but can I tell you, it will not stand when the judge of heaven stands and says, where were you when I called? Where were you when I spoke? And you'll say, when did you speak to me, Lord? When did you call? I thought I knew you. And they said, when Pastor Philip and Pastor Jolly preached, you heard the message, but you didn't open your heart. You heard the message, but you folded your arms. You heard the message, but you didn't like the preacher. Can I tell you, he wasn't preaching for his glory. He was preaching for mine. He was preaching by the power and the Holy Spirit tonight to set captives free. And all your religion, all your legal arguments, all your conspiracy theories mean nothing if you haven't received me. That's the name. That's the person of Jesus. Jesus is saying, you need to receive me. This is a personal decision. I love the altar call. I love to call people forward to receive Jesus. But maybe there is no altar to call you to tonight. But it's time for you to receive Jesus where you are. You don't come in a crowd. You come as an individual. So come to Jesus. Fall on your knees if you're able. If you need healing, come to Jesus. Everything you need is in Jesus and him alone. You say, well, I need financial breakthrough. I need money for this bill and that bill. Can I tell you, your answer is still Jesus. Come to Jesus first. Let Jesus clean up your act. Let Jesus transform your situation. Let Jesus use you to create something new. Oh, this is how you get free. This is how you develop in this world. You carry Jesus into the place Jesus needs to be. Glory to God. Glory to God. It's time. It's time for you to receive Jesus. I want to invite you right now. The Word of God says, if you believe in your heart, and if you confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord and that he went to the cross for your sin and that he rose from the grave to prove his power, then you will be saved. But what you hear, you don't believe Jesus with your mind. You don't believe Jesus with your thoughts. You believe Jesus with your heart. The heart is the heart of love. It's not the mind of love. Have you ever heard somebody say, oh, my heart's all a flutter because I'm in love with this person? They never say my mind is all a flutter because I'm in love with this person. They say I've lost my mind and my heart is ruling. Can I tell you, it's the same with Jesus. You lose your mind and let your heart reign and rule in this decision to encounter Jesus with all your heart, with all your love. You love from here, not from here. Oh, glory to God. It's time for you to say, I love you, Lord. I love what you've done. I love you that you never left me tied up. You wanted to release me. I love you, Lord, that you've not left me stranded. You've brought disciples into my life. You've brought anointing and mantles upon me. Oh, Lord, I want to carry your presence. And if it's a journey of tough hardship, higher and higher, I'm still going to press on so that I can walk with you and go into the next thing with God. Glory to God. This is my heart's desire for you to be free. This is the desire of Jesus. That's why Jesus came. He wants you free indeed, not tied to the world, not tied to your situation, but in the world, but in Christ, in peace, and to prosper as your soul prospers. Can I tell you, if you've made a commitment to Jesus, Jesus is called, Jesus has committed already to you. Oh, no more running from your Father in heaven. Run to him and embrace him in these days. Fellowship with him. Get yourself into a good church if you're not in one already. Get yourself into the Word of God if you're not reading it already. Get yourself into the worship music. You know, you can find worship music just about anywhere. Just say, find me Christian songs. And there's a version of the music for you to listen to there that you'll enjoy. But you know what? Remember, it's about worshiping God and not about you. Remember that it's all about him and not about you. And when you put Jesus first, when you put Jesus in his rightful place, he's going to take you on to victory. Yes, it might seem like days are dark. Yes, it might seem like days are difficult. But with Christ, all things are possible. With Christ, all things are possible. And I want to pray for your miracle right now. I want to speak healing over your physical, mental, whatever condition you find yourself in right now. Somebody with kidneys, kidney failure, kidney stones, kidney problems, kidney infection. I see that right now. I perceive that right now. So right now, those that are suffering with their kidneys right now, I release the anointing of Jesus of Nazareth. What Jesus has given me, I give to you freely right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Be healed. And there, the anointing of healing is going to those who have kidney problems right now. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. There's somebody with pain in their shoulder. There's somebody with pain here. And right now, I just speak healing in the mighty name of Jesus. The fire of God come upon you. It cleanse and burn up every sickness right now. I command those muscles, the sprains and strains to be healed in Jesus' name. I command spinal columns to come into alignment and trapped nerves to be released. Rotator cuffs to come into alignment. I speak new shoulders into being right now. New collarbones in the mighty name of Jesus. There's somebody with a deformed foot. I see it right now. And in the mighty name of Jesus, I say come into alignment. I command the hips to rotate so that there's no more duck feet or waddling feet. Their feet are in aligning right now, and those legs are lined up in Jesus' name. I command your spinal column to do that and your pelvis to come into alignment and rotate right now in Jesus' name. I command those with back pain for your legs to grow out right now in Jesus' name, and the spinal column just to be in the right curve in the mighty name of Jesus of Nazareth. Oh, glory to God. There's somebody with headaches and sickness and diarrhea right now in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, I lay my hands upon you in Jesus' name. And I say, come out, Satan. Come out, you sickness, you foul disease. In the mighty name of Jesus, I say, rise up and be healed this very hour in Jesus' name. I speak to those with these cancers, those with these growths. Right now, I curse cancer. I curse tumors. And I squeeze the life out of them in Jesus' name. And I cast them into the sea in the mighty name of my Jesus, my Lord and my God. And I bind you, Satan. I bind you, you liar, you devil who's speaking negativity and worry and fear over somebody. I bind you right now. Those that are speaking foulness and sick things, I curse you and I command you to leave and never return in the mighty name of Jesus. Glory to God. Oh, somebody's knee is being healed. I see it right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Somebody with a liver disease right now, in Jesus' name, that and gallstone area, all something wrong there right now. I release the power of God to heal you. Father in heaven, receive all the glory. Father in heaven, release angels to minister to those who are in need tonight. Father, receive the glory of God on earth. Receive it, the people's praise. Receive their worship and their thankful hearts, Father. Be pleased with us, Father. Pour out your gifts and your surprises upon us, Lord. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for the work you've done. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for the fact that you're here. Oh, God, with us. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. And so, Father, we commit these words. We commit this message to your keeping, knowing that you can take it into the heart and the minds and the lives and the spirits of those who need life everlasting. Glory to God in the mighty name of Jesus. I just pray for those with COVID and symptoms of COVID, with anything related, whether it be vaccine related or COVID related, anything that's going on in the nations right now. I speak peace. And I break lies and I speak healing in the mighty name of Jesus, from the highest house to the lowest house, to those with no house, be all healed in Jesus' mighty name. I speak a hedge of protection around the body of Christ so that they might walk out in the healing power of Jesus Christ and heal the sick around them. Glory to God. Glory to God. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Father, we just commit our government into your hands. Oh, Father, we pray for our government. We pray for our leaders. We pray for our church leaders, Father. We pray for the ministry. We pray for those that are in service, evangelists in the fivefold, the pastors, Father. Oh, Father God, the prophets and the apostles, Father, the teachers. Oh, glory to God, Father, touch them all. Touch your church, Father, in these days. Pour out revival, Lord, revival fire. May it come in our days in Jesus' mighty name. We're longing for your return, Lord. But Father, may your will be done until that day. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Thank you, my beloved brother. Thank you, Pastor.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Powerful word of God. Lots of healing happened, especially the kidney people. Okay. Healing happened. Kidney stone. Praise the Lord. Related to kidney stone, right now you could receive the healing. Many people, not for one person, the multiple people received the healing. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And liver disease. Praise the Lord. Fatty liver people, you are received the healing. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And lots of healing happened. Okay. You have allergic disease. Lots of healing happened. We can give wonderful clap to Jesus Christ because there's powerful healing. And powerful word of God. Praise the Lord. The triumph end of Jesus Christ in the Jerusalem, the Palm Sunday is going to come right now. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So the triumph end of Jesus Christ, triumph entry, that means wherever Jesus Christ's presence was there, there was the, you know, that one, the people, those who are doing against the God, the people who are there, it was, they were going out. Praise the Lord. Jesus Christ was putting them out of the temple, from the temple. Praise the Lord. That means Jesus Christ's temple is a holy temple. Today is our temple is, Jesus Christ's temple is our body. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah, our heart. So that what all the things are there, any of the buying or selling, like that kind of any of the satanic activities are going on in our heart, we have to drive out, we have to take out them. Then only we can receive the healing in your body. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Pastor Philip. We'll finish in the 10 minutes time. We'll finish it. Praise the Lord. Sister, closing, are you there? Can you invite you to sing one song? Are you there? If you are there, thank you.
Hallelujah, glory to God. We thank God for the word, the powerful word that came out through Pastor Philip. God bless you and God increase you. We need Jesus. We need the power of the Lord. And that's because he is the light of the world. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. You know, and he also said, I am the light of the world. So this world needs Jesus. So we're going to worship God with this song that says, light of the world. Hallelujah. Amen.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. This is a final session. We'll finish on the 5-minute time. Already, Pastor already prayed for the sick people. You know, I need to pray again. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Only one thing, one Bible verse I want to say to all the people. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. This is what Book of Psalms, chapter 46, verses 1 says, King David was saying, God is our refuge and strength and very present help in trouble. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We are living in this world. Our God is a present help. in our trouble. Praise the Lord. The situations will come against us. The circumstances will come against us. Our God will protect you. How many of the people are having an experience in this pandemic time? Praise the Lord. Maybe most of the people, they were not having that job. You don't know how to survive everything, but our God was protecting you. Praise the Lord. In your trouble, our God was the greatest protection. Our God was giving a greatest protection in your life. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So that everybody, each and every people, you are having an experience in Lord. Praise the Lord. That is what the Bible says. The book of Psalm chapter 107 verse 28 says, and then they cry out to the Lord their trouble, and he brings them out of their distresses. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Everything our God will give you. The will of God is always 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. Our God will help you. This is the intention of our Lord towards you. Praise the Lord. This is what our God went to the Jerusalem to our God drive out everything, all the things which was happening against in that temple, because our God want to make a prepare a place for you. This is what our God was doing in this world. This is what John chapter 14, our God was saying, I'm going before you to make a place for you. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So that our God has already made a place for you in the heaven. That is what Apostle Paul said. I'm not looking at any of the things are coming against our life. I'm looking the forward. I'm looking at the heaven. That is our God has prepared for me a crown before the foundation of the world. Praise the Lord. For eternal glory, there's a price our God has kept for you. So that this is according to this word of God, Pastor Philip was saying, praise the Lord, during the songs, sister was singing, and our prayer and everything, it was focusing to you. Our God has appointed you as an apostle to the nations. This is the greatest revival our God has given in your hand today. If this is a greatest week according to the Christian life, praise the Lord, it's a holy week. That whether it is that time or not, that one it happened or not, we are not, but all the world are following. This is a history. Jesus Christ, there was a triumphal entry in the Jerusalem temple. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. There is a crucifixion of Jesus Christ. This is a history. Praise the Lord. Resurrection of Jesus Christ. This is a history. Jesus Christ is resurrected, still living God. This is a reality. This is a history and a reality. So we are following this Jesus Christ. This Jesus Christ is saying, in your trouble, I am your helper. So that all the people, once again more, I want to encourage to all the people, raise up your hand. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Maybe you are crying today. Maybe already you have received the healing in your body. Praise the Lord. Once again more, you are praying one accord. Praise the Lord. Any other people are thinking, when if you are having any of the doubt in your heart, we are praying to the Lord to take away your doubtless mind from your heart, so that then only our God can send his healing power in your body. Praise the Lord. Whoever is having tensions, our God cannot do his duty. Whoever is having that, if anybody is trusting in God, our God can do the miracle in their life. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. The leper, he was having the trust. That blind person, he was trusting in Lord. That person who was having the 38 years, he was waiting to get the touch from the Lord, the pool of Bethesda. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And the woman, she was having the 12 years raw blood. She was trusting in God. Who are trust the Lord, they could receive the glory of the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Raise up your hand. What a God. We are going to pray for you. We are going to bless you right now. What all the things are coming against your life, we are going to pray to the Lord. Our God will take away from your body, from your mind, from your heart as well right now in Jesus' name. I want to encourage to all the people, all the ministers in our group, please raise your hand. We are praying one accord to the Lord. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I pray for each one of them. Father God, if any of the things are coming against anybody's life, the people are watching all right, Father, to accept your glory, to receive your healing power in their heart. If any of the satanic activities is there happening in their heart, in Jesus' name, first of all, we cast out by the blood of Jesus Christ, in the name of Jesus Christ, we cast out from their body, from their mind, from their heart, right now, in Jesus' name, God, right? We release the victory right now. We release the freedom right now. In Jesus' name, the people are watching online. Already Pastor prayed for the liver problem. The liver functions are normal. not normal. Again, I want to pray only for that one. Liver functions are not normal. Praise the Lord. The people are watching, not only for one person. Praise the Lord. A few people are watching for their liver functions are not over. So that you are facing great trouble in that one. In Jesus' name, what all the things are coming against their life, Father, not only their liver, any of the parts of their body, in Jesus' name, by the blood of Jesus Christ, this is a reality. By your stripes, we are healed. We are healed, already healed. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. This is a 500 years to birth of Jesus Christ. Prophet Isaiah prophesied about the healing power of Jesus Christ. By his stripes, we are healed. Praise the Lord. In Jesus' name, we declare the healing right now. Receive the healing in your body, in your mind, in your heart, in your liver, and everything. Receive in Jesus' name. I pray for all the sick people. Anybody suffering any kinds of infirmities, any of the people are suffering, facing any of the afflictions from your colleagues or friends or anybody. In Jesus' name, you cast out right now. In Jesus' name, we release the total restoration in your life. In Jesus. Once again more, I pray for, I want some, the people are suffering the sickness. I want you to say from your mouth, I receive. Praise the Lord. You have to say, I receive. Then only you can receive it. Okay. Please say, I want to encourage you everybody. Please say, I receive from your mouth. Then you are receive the healing. Okay. In Jesus' name. And also, I pray for shake the nations, non-stop gospel revival. Shake the nations, TV gospel revival. I pray for Father, Heavenly Father, in Jesus Christ, who are supporting by seed, Heavenly Father, I bless them, Father, in Jesus' name. Who are supporting, the people are supporting by prayer, I bless them, Father, in Jesus' name. The pastors, those who are in this flight home, Father, I pray for Pastor Philip and Sister Tosin, Brittany and Vinicha, Pastor Mike, everybody, keep them in your glory, Father. Give more anointing and power, Father. Let them run for gospel, with the gospel, extra miles, Father. I pray for all the pastors, all the participants, those who had been in this right room, those who are going to come in this right room, all the worshipers and roots. Keep them in your glory, Father, in Jesus. Once again, more I pray for everything. What all the needs, shake the nation's need, Father. Everything we are giving in your hand, in Jesus' name. Somebody want to shout and say, Amen. Praise the Lord, hallelujah. Everything happened, okay. Prayer is powerful. Lots of healing happened. Okay, lots of healing. This is a miracle journey. We are expecting the lots of test message. Praise the Lord. Coming days. Is it why we are trusting this much in God? That means when Pastor Jolie was praying in the street, every day I'm seeing the miracle. You can see in the video. Praise the Lord. So that Pastor Jolie is trusting. Pastor Philip is trusting, trusting in God. Sister Tosin is sitting, trusting. And everybody is trusting in Jesus Christ because this Jesus Christ is a healer. Praise the Lord. So that everybody, check your body, shake your hand and your body, kneel down and get up and jump and dance. The things which you cannot do, you do it today. You are already received the restoration in your life. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We are waiting to hear your testimony at the other time. See you tomorrow at 6 o'clock on UK time. God bless you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.